And right now we have no viewers, so we're good with that.
Woo! We are our own audience.
Exactly. At the end of the day, the main point of this VOD is really just record what we do, so you guys can go back on it later. Other than that, hey, if I make some cash off this, that'd be great.
Woohoo! Right.
So, I believe the stream is working correctly. This little bit of light is some pixie that follows you guys around, who complains and tells you answers because it is technically Twitch chat personified in the game. So people actually show up, start giving you answers. That's where the answers are coming from. You should ignore those answers because they could be lying to you, and you know it. The internet lies a lot.
No one lies on the internet.
That's exactly what the internet wants you to believe.
Well, everything you find on the internet's absolutely true. It has to be. Isn't that the rules?
Congratulations, you proceeded in making the internet bigger.
I thought that was on the contract. Everything you say must be the truth.
Exactly.
ODM.
Yes, what is it?
When we looted our previous party's corpses.
I think you did, didn't you?
Yeah, did we find that lighter and the music box that Grimble made? As well? I don't remember
the
that.
The lighter would survive. I'm going to say the music box would have corroded over, like, the years. Straight damp in there, you know?
Okay.
So, yeah, you can have the lighter.
Okay.
Yeah, for the most part, anything that would survive for those years in a damp cave would have survived.
Okay.
Let's see here. Let's see if we can find a way to make music actually feasible right now. Because right now I have it set up by playing audio in Roll 20, but I have two windows open. So if I have two windows open, it plays both audio, and that's why the echo's going.
So I turned the audio off in Roll 20.
Yeah, but the main thing is I can't turn it off and still have it be heard on stream, you know?
Ew.
So let me take a short minute and throw up at least some music. So we have something going on in the background.
I don't think it's me this time.
Alright, just leave something in the back so we're not completely silent in between sessions. I mean, in between whatever we're doing. Alright, let's go ahead and do a quick recap. What do you guys remember from last time?
We went through that dungeon a lot, actually. Found quite a lot of those minotaurs and...
Let's see. Yeah, compared to last time, you went through everything you've done before.
Oh yeah, we did that and more so.
Indeed.
We didn't even get those storm minotaurs last time.
Yeah, mainly they were there, man. You heard the like banging and crashing of those things moving around.
Yeah.
But you never actually got in to go, you know, see what it was. Because you died immediately after. Alright. So, Draco is over here and currently unconscious.
Oh, I'm a black screen still.
Oh, one sec, one moment then. That should fix it.
Oh, yeah. Loop turn order. Okay, so this is after a long rest.
Give me a brief moment and I'll tell you in a sec. Alright. Can I get everyone to roll me a D1000? And I'm rolling for a friend who's currently not around.
Oh, that's a high one.
Ooh, wow. I got high.
Okay, well, during the night when you guys are resting, you wake up to a very hot morning. The sun's beating down. You are pretty close to the desert, so it's still relatively hot where you are. But the moment today when you wake up, it's just scorching hot. Whoever was taking the last watch, you were just like so hot, man. Drenched in your own sweat. The tiger would run into the cave because it's nice and cool in there, you know? As for your horse and your donkey, what are you doing, the four of you, as you wake up, as they're getting to the point where they're... Hello. And Horatio has returned. Or not. There's also a little bit of background noise coming from somewhere.
I don't think I have anything.
Dink, are you there?
Yeah.
Alright, so making sure you haven't said anything wrong. But yeah, you wake up to the horses being dehydrated, and they don't look very well.
How close are we to the nearest water source?
It'll be a while. You actually brought water with you, which is...
We don't have a bucket or anything either, eh?
No, you don't. It's like you would give them water whenever you thought they wanted water, you would give them water. But you can't force a horse to drink water, which is the old adage, and it's very much true. And I'm going to go ahead and restart the Skype call so Horatio can get back in, okay?
Yeah.
Nope.
Did it work?
Horatio's still connecting.
Well, we'll see in a moment then.
Quick question. Would they drink the,
the dragon water?
Yeah.
I was thinking that.
You could try it.
And try and get them through through the dungeon, though.
That actually would be the best option, since you don't like carry a trough with you, I assume.
Well, yeah. We did, all, at least I did. I filled up my water skin with it.
But we don't have something for the horses to drink out of. Like, they can't drink from the canteen.
It'd be very hard to do that. Yeah. I think he's back. Can you hear us all right?
Yep.
All right, connection issues. It's mark of every great D&D show.
No, it only happens on Skype, not the actual internet. It's strange.
Yeah, well, Skype does, like, mess up quite often, actually.
Skype does what it wants.
Okay. Well, Deacon's got a helmet. So he's just going to turn it upside down and pour some water into it, some of the dragon fountain water, and see if we can at least get the mule to drink.
Right, roll me an Adam Handling check. DC shouldn't be too hard, but we'll see how that works for you guys.
Animals check. Oh, I've got a proficiency. Yay!
Okay. Ooh. Yeah, on a 22, you can get 24. Your mule. I think it's yours, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah, you can get your own mule to drink the water. No real issue there. The horse that's belongs to someone else, and those will be a little more of an issue. But yeah, your donkey or mule seems a little better. He's been grazing, but you're starting to notice as you look around that this heat is causing a lot of the grass and the vegetation around you to start like wilting away already. It's just that hot out.
It's only morning, and it's that freaking hot.
It's literally just morning at this point.
Is it too hot to travel?
What you're getting the sense is that the wind is picking up and the dry air from the desert wafting across you guys, and it's causing a feeling of it being hotter than it really is, you know?
What are we, about one day's hard travel away from the river?
Let me take a look at the popular to the world map. Yeah, about one day's travel, you head west from there. You could probably attempt to climb the mountain. Admittedly, it wouldn't be that much colder. But yeah, if you head due west of here, you should really hit the river, which heads out into the ocean.
Well, you said we could do 2 squares a day since we're all on horseback, right?
The main issue now is that since these horses are, I think, considered emaciated or dehydrated, they wouldn't be able to travel as fast, so they get at least one day.
All right, then. So,
Can we follow that river and, like, the shoreline pretty much the way back to Fool's Bluff?
That's feasible. Just be aware that you can't really drink seawater, though.
Yeah, see, the river he's talking to is to the west of us. The one to, that I was wondering if we get to the lake itself and then just mainly the lake up.
That's not a freshwater lake going into the sea?
You want to head east to the lake? Yeah, you could head east to the lake.
Yeah,
and that'd be drinkable water. I mean, you don't want to drink standing water, but it's better than salt water, yeah? But you wouldn't be able to travel one square a day, considering the way the horses are right now. Unless you would like to go back into the dungeon and just grab water.
I'm honestly thinking of like leading the horses into that area with the dragon fountain and just stay here another day, just so it's not so hot.
Well, if we were going to do that, we'd have to kill Mushroom Bob. We've just been bypassing him.
Oh, yeah. If you wanted to get past him with the horses, you would have to kill him this time. There's no way this horse is going to willingly walk past a giant moving mushroom.
We only went up north in a dungeon. There was another way south, which we didn't check.
There was?
Yes, there is.
I'd like to get the horses to the water source, though. And then we could explore more. And get them out of the heat, really, because they're going to dry up out here. And if we try to walk them back, they're just going to... Yeah, I'm going to feel bad for them.
That's y'all's call. You know me. I want to go back into the dungeon, but if, you know...
Right. Also, did we ever determine what time of year it was?
You did. I assumed it was summer because it was so hot.
Yeah, and, like, I'm going to assume it's summer because it's really hot out. But I never actually did determine the exact weather. Because I did last time, but then you died.
That was 3 years ago.
That was 3 years ago, so the weather is definitely different. Let me see if I can find my notes for it. Google Docs, the most awesome thing in the world. They work out so well. Alright, matchstick.
Control F.
Alright, assuming that we're literally within the same season, the last noted weather season was... We are at we just passed spring, it's summer now.
Okay.
So, currently summer. And we haven't really spent enough time for we can consider weather changing, so it's just the summer heat right now.
I wouldn't mind exploring this dungeon a little bit more. But for this... I wonder if... Would I be able... Is there more trees nearby? Or do we, like, take all the nearby stuff down for Tim's funeral?
I guess you would have cut down some trees that would have been nearby in order to, you know, light on fire, but...
Yeah.
There wasn't exactly a large amount of woods in your immediate area.
Yeah. I was just thinking if there was actually, like, a bigger tree, I could actually just quickly make a trough for the horses.
Hmm. Yeah, it wouldn't be impossible, but if you want to head...
I do have a wood axe.
Hmm. Well, you have a wood axe. You have any actual... Well, let's not talk about nails. What does he do without? Sure. Give me
It's basically just like carving out a big scoop out of a tree.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah, you could do that. That's pretty nice thinking there. So give me... I want to say it's more like athletics.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, because it's more about strength rather than anything else. It's not like you're making out of like some intricate material.
It's yeah, it's it would be hard to make.
All right, give me athletics check.
Can I do a help action with him?
I'm proficient with
athletics. Yeah, if you're proficient with athletics, you would be able to give him advantage. Are you?
I am proficient with it. It's honestly +7, and I get 12.
Yeah. So if you guys are proficient with that skill, you can help him with it. Do you have that proficiency with athletics?
No, but I do have guidance.
Guide me towards the tree.
Had you, so if you declared it before he rolled his outcome, you could have done it.
Oh.
It's not, you know, you can't do it retroactively.
Okay, okay.
Well, we're not under, like, any duress or anything, so it would just take longer, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll allow it. Go ahead and give him guidance and he can get another shot. Otherwise, okay. You're going to start noticing, like, it's just not working, you know?
No problem.
Go ahead and roll the D4 for guidance, I believe. And he'll just have that added onto his athletics.
Efficient. I don't think I actually have the roll set up for it. Darn.
Or do you want me to roll it?
Nope, I don't. Yeah, just go ahead and roll it. I'll give it to you. That way, if you fail, it's on you.
Yeah, really. Oh, no,
oh, there's a 4, man. Come on. Roll the athletics. I'm sure you got this. Alright, on 19, you will succeed. You managed to cut down a nice, big, thick tree, and you carve it out, and there's a little enough room in there for your water. How much water do you actually guys have?
We filled up our canteens with the dragon water.
And plus, we also had the barrel that was on the side of the cart.
Alright.
Can we fill that barrel up with dragon water, too?
No. I'm just saying we left with water in it.
Oh, yeah, but...
how much left?
Fill it up with that.
You wouldn't be able to fill up more than like half the barrel because the fountain's not that deep.
Okay.
But if you want, you could go there and spend time just skipping in there. It's really up to you guys. But yeah, if you want to do that, then go ahead and dump all your water into this trough for the horses. They'll drink it.
Yeah, we'll do that.
We'll use a barrel water though.
All right. So you take the barrel, you dump it in there. You've essentially used up your pretty much the entire bulk of your bear rust.
We're essentially going to be on our way back.
Yeah, so you use up all your water, give it to the horses. They'll be fine. You do have more little bits of water in the form of rations, which is why you guys consume them every time you rest. So, yeah, they seem to be fine. Anything else? Do you guys still want to head back in, or do you want to head out before the weather might get worse? You don't know.
I mean, we have enough rations to stay here a few days, even if the water gets worse.
We're starting to get low on rations, aren't we?
If you go through the forest, you can definitely hunt for rations.
Yeah, we really didn't use anything in the way of rations on the way down here. The only time we used rations were actually in the dungeon.
Yeah, when you were in the dungeon, I believe you also might have consumed rations. If you pass through the desert, you will be consuming rations.
Yeah.
What y'all's call? So, I'm just gonna say before we leave, though, at least Gideon's gonna go back in there, re-top off with some dragon well water, and check those rooms where we hit the last Gorgon. Nobody has to come with him if y'all don't want to.
I'll come with you. Just for protection, really.
If we're all going, I'm going too.
Okay. We'll check out that last room, because we have quite an amount of business to do in town.
So as you guys be prepared to head back inside, you do note a few birds flying across the sky. Since it would be very windy, a lot of them are moving about as their nests or homes are being jostled around. You see them floating around above you. There's also a vulture, which is a little ominous, but at the end of the day, vultures are scavengers. They're not going to attack you in any way.
Mm-hmm.
But if you ever met a real vulture, they're as big as you guys, essentially. Or, you know, you're a halfling from there. Alright. You guys will proceed into the dungeon. Let me hop you back to the map. Damn, that shift tab is not working today. There we go. So, what do you guys want to do?
We just want to check out that last room, eh?
Yeah.
Okay. Remember the way, Gideon?
Yes, I do.
Alright.
Lead the way then.
Okay, is Mushroom Bob still in the room?
Yes, he is. Though I don't think he's on the map at the moment. There he is.
Ah, yeah, there he
he's
is.
Sitting back in the same little spot he was earlier.
Okay, no problem.
I believe it's a will save, correct?
I'm looking at it now. There it is. Yep.
Okay, with some saving throws into DC, what's your DC?
My DC is... Where is it? It's under spells.
Alright, well, it should be totally fine, as he rolled a 7.
Okay. Yes, I've got a will DC of 15.
Alright. So on the 7, you succeed, and you guys manage to make your way safely across.
Okay, off we go then.
I'm just going to go ahead and move you guys there, as it's relatively unnecessary. Bob's the only issue that you had in that moment.
Thank you, thank you.
So you guys are over here.
Okay, obviously going to go top off of the Dragon Well water. Which is right up here.
Yes, okay. To the top north there.
And then once we do that, I want to check out the area that's marked as 9.
Alright. So once you check the well seems exactly as it was before.
Was this the room that he busted?
Now that you take a better look at it,
you
actually notice that there's more water coming out of it than normal, but it's still the same level. It's equally coming in as it is leaving. So the level stays the same, but you do notice that there's more water coming in today.
Okay.
Alright. Anything else? You just head to the next room?
We all just stop off and...
Taking a look at the doorway before I step in.
That's the broken doorway. That's the hole that the Minotaur made.
That's the hole the Minotaur made. Just, like, wrecked right through it.
Okay, so...
It's an artificial door.
Yeah, I guess we're heading in.
Yep.
So as you look to the area that I will mark in a moment, along here, there's a large amount of hay just like stacked up in the corner. A lot of it's debris and other like bits of metals, a few swords and other things just packed into the corner there.
No problem. We'll go through it and search it.
Yeah, and if there's any nice metals amongst those weapons, my main focus.
All right. So let's go individually. So, Horatio, is there anything you want to look for in this like pack of... Essentially, it looks like debris or trash, essentially. But...
Well, if there's arrows, I would like to pick some up, because I've used some of mine already.
Alright, roll me a perception check.
Perception. That's bad.
Yes, unfortunately you don't find arrows, which admittedly was like rolling to find a needle in the haystack. Alright. Dink, what are you looking for? There's a few noticeable weapons, some hay, you know, rocks, debris, it looks like a few animal parts in there as well.
Yeah, just go ahead and take some time to separate out the stuff that's worth it from the stuff that's not. I mean, a couple weapons are no big deal, but we can always sell them, that kind of thing. Bits and pieces of armor, and just going through the general pile. I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty, even though the orc's all squishy.
Yeah.
All right, so you're taking your time. You're not really in a rush. You're just, like, shuffling through it, see what's good, what isn't. What stands out to you immediately is a very odd-looking pendant. Seems to be like tied around this rather short-looking dagger. Just like, sort of like as you move through a bunch of stuff, you've seen like other things, but this dagger is curved rather than straight.
It's a dagger.
Yes.
Okay.
But this amulet is just like attached to the bottom, almost like the what is it called? It's called a pommel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it just dangles there though.
Okay, we'll throw it in the party loot and take a look at it later as we can.
Alright. And, Rook, give me an investigation check.
Give you a what? Investigation.
No, Rook. He's trying to find precious metals, apparently.
Oh, okay.
Well, anything that stands out. God damn it.
Well, unfortunately, on the 7, not really much stands out. A lot of iron in the form of steel and other like metals, but
yeah.
None of them are precious or really outstanding in any way. No, man. It's like, you come across a few more bits of like cobalt, but it's... You assume that it molts, but you note that the cobalt that's here is kind of rusted and just like crumbling.
Okay.
Okay, we see no other way out of this room except for the two doors down in the southwest corner, correct?
It is not hidden, you just didn't have it revealed, but there is a little bit of a hallway down there.
Yeah.
Okay. I'll take a walk down there.
Alright.
Anybody else coming?
Yes.
I guess I'm not finding anything nice with those weapons, so, yeah.
Alright, Rock, do you want to stop?
Spend some more time looking, maybe you'll find something. Right. We all have dark vision, right?
I do have dark vision.
I do have dark vision.
I also have dark vision.
There we go!
We all have dark vision.
It's good. It's always good to have an entire party with dark vision.
Yeah, we got another party on a different night that's starting out. It's specifically built for the Underdark. 3/4 of the group is human.
Oh my god.
Please tell me one of them is a warlock with some, like, 120 feet dark vision, right?
The warlock is a half-elf.
So the one who can see, yeah. Obviously, is one of the only classes that gives them that.
And honestly, I called him out on it. It's like, specifically, he told you, this thing is going into the Underdark, and you brought people without dark vision. It's on you, bro.
I will admit, I enjoy playing a drow, just walking around in the sunlight. So hard to hit anything, but that's why you go for spells that are
roll,
like saving throws instead of attacks.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is great sometimes, because they don't expect you to hit anything.
Okay, so, Ruck, did you want to take a little more time to look, or are you done?
I want to. There's weapons and metals in here. I want to take a good look through. We've been finding some cool stuff so far.
No problem.
All right, man.
It's probably going to be really bad.
All right, go ahead and roll another investigation, as I believe Gideon, at least, is heading in.
Oh, Gideon.
Damn it!
Wow.
Dude, wow.
My investigation's bad.
Before you guys head in, Brooke, they leave, but what you end up finding is what looks to be like the remnants of an egg. The shell's actually metallic, and the inside seems to be a bit of ceramic. It's like, it's almost looks natural.
That's really weird.
Do we suspect that this is probably a Gorgon egg?
Or the remnants of one.
Okay, cool. We don't see any other eggs in there, whole ones, do we?
No solid eggs anywhere.
Okay.
Right.
That's cool. I guess this is a little worthless, but still cool.
Yeah.
Do we keep it?
We have to eat it.
Yes.
At
this point, Gideon and them have just started walking down the hallway when you found
them. Oh. Hmm. Right. I'll keep it anyway. I like to keep things.
Okay. And it goes down and into a corner.
Okay, stopping at the corner to make sure to look around it before I just go stepping out.
All right, roll me perception then.
Perception! Dun-dun-dun!
Okay, so on a passive 17, what you catch is this slight glint, and you take a step back real quick. As you see, I'm just going to draw a quick line. It's not physically there impeding your way, but it's just like a little thread just like hanging along the wall.
Thread.
Seems silk-like.
Like spider web?
Yes.
Not going in there. Big, yucky, poisonous spider things. Either that or I'll just wait for Ruck.
As you stand there, waiting a little bit longer, and Rook's heading up, you think you see like a leg just barely making the corner.
A leg. Okay, then I am going to back up to this corner, and I am going to cast Bless on the three of us.
You cast Bless?
Yes.
And at this point, we're going to go ahead and roll initiative.
All right.
Oh, what's going on? I got blessed.
Yeah, spider dude, spiders. Big hairy ones. At least all I saw was a leg, but we also see spider webs, so where's one, the other?
No.
It's bound to be there.
Yeah, initiative and work the dragon. There we go.
Okay, well, we have spider initiative, and we have everyone else's. And setting it from descending, tallying the silver leaf.
I honestly thought it was a trap.
Ready action, my bow, like prepare an arrow, and as soon as the spider appears, I'm gonna shoot it.
Well, it's your turn, so yeah, you can ready an action, and as a reaction, you can take the shot. It is now the spider's turn. Alright, so it begins to crawl out along the wall, making its way over here. It's actually about 10 feet up, so you can still take an upswing at it. It's not at disadvantage or anything, but admittedly, if it decided to, it could climb along the roof and he'd just be out of your range. But right now, he's still just climbing along the wall, but he still goes. And Tillian, too, if I want, think you want to take a shot, man, go for it.
Yeah, I'm going to take a shot with sharpshooter. Defeats. So, where is it? Long ball. Here it is.
Nice! On the crit.
Okay, very nice. Okay. Damn.
You hit him for 18 plus 7, which is 25.
Fine.
Way to go, man. Really nice shot. And as you strike into it, it almost looks like the spire just turns to dust and disappears, but he's just barely there, almost like he's just like missed or something. But he's still moving. And his eyes begin to glow as it sort of just waits for you.
So we just saw him take that much damage.
Oh. You saw him take a really good, like a really on-point arrow, and it.
And it didn't do anything really.
It I don't know. Its form shimmered.
Yeah, his form kind of shifted. Also, there's a big eye on there. Let me take a look, so you can get a good look at that.
Holy bejeebus!
That eye is what's glowing and just staring at you right now.
Let's maybe back off.
All right.
That thing's creepy as hell.
Gideon Rain, it is your turn.
Well, obviously, well, I don't know what these guys are doing, but I'm backing out into the big room.
As you begin to back out, you feel something yanking on your foot as you realize that you stepped on some of the silk earlier. You have half movement speed.
I have half my movement.
Yes.
Okay.
He is not close enough to get a reaction, so you should be good.
Well then, I am going to go ahead and cast a spell. And bingo, there it is.
Oh!
Oh god.
Oh man.
You take your shot, and it looks like it hits true, but it seems like the creature just disperses and reappears around it. Shot completely miss.
Great.
Ruth, your turn.
I gotta move up and try and get in front of them.
Yeah, you can't see it at this point either, can you?
No. He's, I don't have view of it.
Yeah.
I just see them shooting at something.
Yeah, you can move through them at, what is it, 5? Your friends are considered rough terrain as you move through them.
And do I have half speed?
While moving through them, yes. Okay. But you haven't stepped in anything like they did.
Okay, so it's 1, 2, 3, so that'd be 15 feet of movement?
You have 30, you have 15.
I already moved one square,
Then
second square is going to be this 15, so that's, I don't have enough to get on the next square.
Alright, also, where are you? Are you underneath someone?
I was.
Okay, just making sure. It's hard to see.
I was right here, so this is 5 feet.
Okay, then 5, right, and then that's 20. 10, that's 15. Let's see. You were there, you moved 5. And then to be on there, you moved 10. So you have, 20 more.
I have 15. Okay.
If you have 30, you have 20 more. So that's another 10. So you have 2 more squares you can move.
Okay. I'll be right in front of them.
All right, you're right in front. You see this little bit of silk attached to Gideon's foot, and you can clearly avoid it. And there's your quarry. He's just along the wall.
I have enough reach to hit him?
Yes.
Well, yes, I'm tall enough. I'm like 7-something.
Yeah, unless he's going to try to purposely move out of range, you're still going to be able to hit him.
Not to mention, you're also rolling at advantage.
Am I? Oh, I am.
Look at the spell description.
It requires it to hit. Actually, sort of like move through it, actually.
Oh, gosh darn it.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to swing at him.
Alright, on a 15... Where is this guy?
And I have, what is it? Bless?
Bless, yeah, it's a 1d4.
Yes, with Bless, you should be able to hit it. Go ahead and roll it.
Hit it!
4, again!
A 4!
Man, I'm doing perfect with Bless.
You strike into this beast. Even with this, like, creepy amount of mist form it's got going on, you manage to cut straight through it, severing it in half, and, like, it literally splits in two while in mist, and reforms on the ground as this already split up
as
creature.
As a corpse?
As a corpse, pretty much.
Ugh.
Yeah, it hits the ground, just like, and it's like begins to curl in. You see no blood come out, but it's still creepy.
So is it like misting instead of bleeding?
Yes, actually.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay, I'm gonna...
As you're the closest one to it, you look at it, and the mist that's coming out of it almost looks like it's forming into really, really tiny spiders and just, like, crawling off.
Fire? Anyone have fire?
Hey, man, that's up to you. Also, we're still in this year. Italian?
I'll just carefully prepare another shot. And wait on my action.
Alright, you prepare an air shot. It's its turn. As far as you're aware, it's not doing anything. Getting rain.
Okay, now did we also see it looking like the mist is little spider things?
You can roll a perception check if you like. It's not an issue of like...
You're kind of too far away
from being able to see it right now, you know?
But I did say, like...
Yeah, you definitely heard
fire.
Folks talking about it.
Oh, you said you needed fire. Okay, cool.
Yeah.
Then I can go ahead and do this then.
And Sacred Flame, which isn't actually fire, is radiant, but I will allow it. As the little bugger has to make a dexterity saving throw, they almost succeeded as they got a 14. And as far as you're aware, you're like managing to kill off these little guys. You get in. You can't see you killing these things, but Rook, you see this little light appear out of nowhere, and they're essentially just burning away from it. And that's the end of combat. You hear some more like clicking noises down the hallway, but you don't think anything's coming closer.
Do we really want to continue going down this hallway, guys?
Well, you wanted to explore.
You wanted to explore.
Okay, I just wanted to check out the room we were just in. If you guys want to go deeper, that's fine. Then we still got two hallways back outside of that room 9. We haven't even looked down. And obviously, these things are a little hard to hit if there's more down there.
We took care of it pretty easily.
Okay.
I just need to have to take a second swing.
All right.
Yeah,
well,
things are pretty easy to hit.
Yeah, if we're going to do this, let's do this quick, because Guiding Bolt, I believe, only lasts for 1 minute.
You mean Bless?
Bless.
Wait, is Guiding Bolt concentration? I don't think it is it?
Yeah, Bless is a concentration spell.
Right. Actually, I remember somewhere where I was told that Guiding Bolt was concentration. I might be incorrect about that. I never actually did check up on it. Do you know?
Guiding Bolt is not a concentration.
Alright, that's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, that's just an attack spell. Why would it be...
I don't know. I remember at one point I was told that. I honestly didn't understand it myself, because it seems a little odd.
Does the... anything else about the corpse, or is it just misting away slowly?
What remains seems to be mostly, like, rock or mineral.
Okay.
Nothing metallic or anything that stands out.
I'm gonna step over it and keep going.
Along the walls, so I won't bother drawing them in, are more of these, like, spider webs and silk and whatnot.
Okay.
You're considered moving half-human speed if you'd like to avoid touching them, though.
Okay, Deacon is actually going to go ahead and light a torch and hand it to Ruck and have him burn it away as he moves forward so we don't have to deal with that.
Oh, gladly. So, walking, like, arms stretched out with this torch forward, like hitting whatever spider webs.
You're just burning them away, okay.
Yep.
All right. As you peer into the hallway, you do see, like, one more of these guys. It's hanging upside down along the roof.
Lee.
Oop. Wrong one.
Talon, can you, hit it to make it fall?
I can try.
Well, if it's on the roof, it's out of our reach, right?
Yeah, if it's on the roof, it's out of your reach, but a melee range attack can still hit it.
I'm gonna then shoot my arrow at it. Shoot an arrow at it.
Alright. Well, if we're gonna do that, let's go ahead and roll initiative. It's clear. Can clearly see you guys. You have a torch.
Yeah.
Oh, great one for Dink.
Oh my god.
That's not bad.
Okay.
Wow.
Well then, guys.
That's bad.
As it sees your archer preparing a bow and arrow, it lunges at Rook.
Eek!
I'm still holding the torch out in front of me.
Unfortunately, you have no, like, feats or abilities that allow you a reaction.
No.
So it just, like, jumps at you, like,
holy bejeez!
Disturbingly little accurate shot as it lunges at you. And it will attempt a bite attack.
Oh no, that misses.
Unfortunately, it misses. As you see it biting, or at least tempting to bite into you, you see this black liquid leaking from its fangs as it attempts to splash at you.
Ew.
Alright. Talion, so relief.
I'm gonna shoot it.
Get it off! Get it off! Get it off!
I'm gonna shoot it.
Alright, go for it.
Don't move! With sharpshooter, by the way.
Oh, okay, nice. Well, there you go.
100%
your arrow
miss.
Shoots clear off into the distance.
Yeah.
Into the distance.
Stop moving, Rock!
Sorry!
I'm gonna help you with that.
And as your arrow clashes against the far wall, you hear some clicking noises in response.
Oh, god.
Rook, what do you do, man?
So it's on me right now, right?
It's physically on you. It's in the
okay.
same tile. You're not grappled unless it attempts to do so next turn.
So I don't have disadvantage on it or anything?
No, you do not.
So I'm just going to swing at it.
Oh!
Well...
You have Bless, but that's not going to help here.
No. I'm going to use Accent Surge, though, to attack again.
Alright, go for it.
Because I would do that.
Yeah, especially considering it's hitting on your face. Very reasonable.
It's on top of me. I want it off.
Right.
Well, on me.
It's up to you whether you think it hit, if you want to roll less. But,
yeah. Yeah, may as well. It won't hurt. I'll roll less if it's still active.
Yes, it is.
Oh my god!
Right. definitely on a 19, you're gonna smack into this creature, and it proceeds to, like, turn into this misty form. And now that you're actually close enough to feel it, it actually feels like it's still there, and as you, like, waft your hand through it, it's just, like, floating around.
All these things are weird, I don't like it.
The worst part is, what little bare skin you have, it feels like little legs crawling all over your arm.
I'm gonna put the torch, like, to where it was, like, to not to actually burn myself, but close.
Alright. That would be an attack, you know, but you can't do that right now.
Oh.
So you're, like, at least you have it out in front of it, like, waving it around, as it still tries to get back on top of you. Gideon Rain.
Alright, Gideon's gonna help him out with... There you go.
Sacred Flame. It succeeds, and takes no damage.
Oh, no.
Damn.
Then I am actually going to continue my movement and get back here behind him.
Alright. You get over there behind him. Yeah, he's got view in this thing from both sides. It continues to, like, wrap itself around your friend here.
Around?
Yeah, he's trying to get around you.
Oh.
He's been trying to grapple you from the beginning. So here is his attempt to grapple you. Roll me... Actually, no, it's not... What is it? Oh, it's just a basic attack. So let's go ahead and just attack you then. So if you're in the net, that'd be a different matter. As it hits a 19, does it hit you?
Yes, it does.
All right, roll a constitution saving throw.
I saw this coming. Oh, 22.
You pass for half damage. You take 11 damage.
I'll just...
Oh.
It's the most disturbing feeling as this venom moves through your veins and you feel like little legs moving through it, man. It's the most disturbing feeling you have in everything you've done. It's, you feel like little beads of something moving along your arm.
Oh my god, I don't like bugs.
It's worse than... Dude, they're literally inside of you. Talion.
Shooting an arrow at it.
Take a shot.
Again.
Oh god, don't miss.
I'll try not to.
I'm on the down side of this arrow.
Good
yeah.
Point.
I got
okay. On a 16, go ahead and roll it.
That's
nice.
Good,
everyone's
yeah.
Getting four. This is the greatest bless we've got to do.
You take a shot into this thing. Your arrow manages to hit it directly in that eye, and it stops glowing. And you see the eye shatter as it hits the floor. It's dead. In the distance,
nope.
You hear more of these clicking noises, and it seems like they're heading your way, though.
I'm gonna get the dragon. Drink some of it, and also pour some on like where he bit me.
When you drink it, you do heal up a little bit, so go ahead and do that.
How much is it?
Oh, I've got that written down in my inventory somewhere. Hold on. I think it's 2d4 plus 2. I'm not sure.
That's a healing potion.
Oh.
No, I've got it written down. I don't have the benefit of it.
I think I healed it last time when I drank that thing.
I would have to check my notes. So if you have it, then let's go with the 2d4 then. So yeah, we'll go with 2d4 plus, what was it? Gideon plus 2 or plus 4?
I think, it's pretty sure it was just plus 2.
Plus 2, so 2d4 plus 2. So go ahead and heal that. Yeah. So as you drink in, as you pour along your arm, you think it helped. You don't feel it moving. The worst part is you feel it like it's still in there.
I still feel the creepy Carly.
You don't feel it moving around, but you can feel it like little bumps along your arm.
Like, is it in my vein or just under the skin?
You think it's? It could be along the vein. It could be just under your skin, but it is adjacent to your veins.
I just scratch at it a bit.
Yes, it is starting to swell up.
It'll never heal.
But it's oh, we
Try and think about something else, man. I'm trying to think all the
it's
things.
It's so gross. There's things inside of me. It's bad.
And
then just like keep scratching my arm.
Sure, man. Waste Guard scenario, you wake up tomorrow and those little spiders crawling out of your arm.
Okay. Right. Wait, we have no arm.
It's still your turn, man. What do you want to do? That was a bonus action to take a drink.
Oh, well, I don't see any other enemies, so, like, that's just...
You can hear them clearly as they come towards you.
Just getting nervous and try and get ready and just try not to think about my arm. And, I will get in front of Gideon, though.
I have dark vision.
We all have dark vision, so...
Yeah, but we still got the torch going, too.
And the torch.
Is this energy correct?
Burning any webs or anything.
Alright.
Actually, that'd probably be my full action, just like burning all the webs I could reach even. And
right.
Go in front of Gideon.
Alright. Talion, it is your turn. You can ready an action if you like.
And yeah, ready another arrow. Get ready for what's to come.
Alright. So, on their turn, you see the first one move in.
First one, that sounds so ominous.
Well, you can see two in the initial order. Take a shot, and the other one will also move in.
We don't meta like that.
No, we don't.
With sharp... Pretty much all my shots are going to use sharpshooter. If not going to use sharpshooter, I'll just say. But for now, I'm just using sharpshooter in every shot.
Alright.
So I don't
roll
think
the
d4,
man.
Oh, another 4.
That's another 4.
What the... This is the greatest blessing you have given us, Giddy. Hey.
Alright.
The gods are in our favors tonight.
Yeah, really. You cut him they don't want us to die. Yeah.
You hit him for 17 damage, and that spider goes into that misty form, as we discussed earlier. This one, who is within, should be within range. Let me take a quick measurement. That is 25 feet. Unfortunately, he's not within range. You see him sort of just staring at you, specifically Brooke.
No.
It's almost like he can see your heartbeat. Gideon Rain, it's your turn.
Okay, the one that Talion shot, that's this one, correct?
The one to the, along the further back.
Oh, further back, okay. No problem, the range isn't an issue anyways. I'm going to hit it with another with the cantrip again.
All right.
Those flames seem to work well on these things.
You hit. It's true, because he rolls horribly on his dex, and you deal 4 more damage to him. You see in this misty form, he distorts quite a bit as the light flashes in front of him. Rook, your turn.
I will definitely move up and try and kill him. 15 to 20.
Alright. If you remember correctly, you're at half moon, so you don't want to accidentally step in one of those webs.
I'll just take 2 steps forward then and keep burning the webs.
Alright, you're burning them away then.
Yep. And okay. The other hand will be the sword.
Okay. Talion.
I'll strike the same one again. With another arrow.
Alright. It hits true, and it goes down, striking it yet again into its eye, and it smashes. Or shatters, I mean, and falls to the floor. Alright. Last remaining spider. Will, of course, take another leaping jump at Rook. Because every spider loves to do that, you know? It just loves doing that. Alright, and here is its bite attack. And 7's not going to hit.
No. Thank
and
God.
That is the end of its turn. Gideon.
Alright, Gideon's going to move up. And we're just going to keep on spamming the cantrip.
Cantrips? Yeah.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Yeah, he took 1 damage at least.
It's something.
It's something.
Alright. Rook. In your mind, you can hear the loud footsteps of the spire just all around you.
Swing at it. Since I have the torch in one hand, this is going to be a one-handed attack.
Alright. Take a swing. As far as you're aware, it hits, dealing... Well, it should be less if it is the torch. So, roll me...
No, I'm swinging with my sword.
Oh, you're swinging with your sword. I thought you were swinging
with
your
torch. I just have the torch. I'm not dropping it, so I'm only swinging one-handed.
Okay, that's fine then. I thought you meant you were swinging at the torch yourself. So you deal 18 damage. Nice. It's still up, though. Talion, you actually start to hear these footsteps, too, and you think they're behind you, man.
Oh, God.
It's not coming back to life. It's a bunch of really tiny ones just crawling along the wall.
Oh, no. Let me check. What can I do? What can I do?
What can you do?
Get this shit.
There's a lot of them there, man.
It's this place, man. Nothing dies. Nothing stays dead here.
Stuff's coming here and shoot the spiders on top of my friend.
Alright, go for it.
Pew.
You hit, dealing 23 damage.
Pew! 23 damage.
That is my max damage with the shot.
That is, yeah.
On another 8, you still hit it in the eye, so if you were trying to keep any of those, they're all breaking.
We don't need no eyes. Where are we going?
It shatters against the floor. That thing is still behind you, man. What do you do?
So, there's something behind this, guys.
Gonna burn them out.
Who's I turn? Think I should do the dungeon now.
Alright, Gideon, go ahead and make your... Actually, no, I have to make a save.
Yeah, let's my see. Spam check.
Alright, the first one makes it. Unfortunately. So those group of spire swords, just like... They literally, as the light appears, they make a circle around it. And can proceed to head towards you guys again. And, Rook, as you turn around, you see these guys also heading towards you.
Oh my god.
Rook, it's your turn. What do you do, man? You have a torch, at least.
Yeah. I'm gonna try and light them on fire.
With the torch.
Alright, you take a swing. For the sake of it, just roll your weapon. Just roll to hit. And assuming it hits, it should work. It does not hit, so it didn't work.
You still got bless?
As long as the minute's not out.
I will allow it. Go for it. It should be running out soon, though.
Yeah.
Oh, it hits! God. It hits! Damn, it hits! Yeah, you killed... Well, there's two packs right there, so you killed one.
I think we're using the same bless... dice.
Yeah, really.
Telling you to still believe.
The gods are favorable to us today.
Damn, I need to
live.
I need to drop something insane on you. You guys are just making all these checks.
We need to get out of here now.
Well,
we need to get out.
Well, the best way out is forward. It's this place. It keeps bringing everything back.
Yes, there is actually a little bit going on there, isn't there? Even your dead bodies came back to life.
Yep. You remember the squishy thing that you got your armor from? It came back, dude. Everything comes back.
Alright, Italian Silverleaf. Go for it.
It's like we're living in a freaking pet cemetery.
Yeah, I was just
you know what? As far as you know, you are in a pet cemetery.
No, that's my movement, I believe, with the lighting.
Let's see. Well... Well, he burnt away the webbing, so there's no issue. So you should be able to get up there if you like. But you would be right up against one of those things.
I'll just do one step and draw my sword and dagger and the flaming one and just be ready.
Oh, that's right, the flaming dagger. There you go.
You know what? Yeah, that's actually pretty good. You finally remember you had it. So you pull out the flaming dagger and you're going to roll to hit with it.
I can do a hit.
You're gonna throw it?
Nah, can't I just, pick them up, stab them?
You could wait for it to come to you and then make a swing.
Yeah,
I'm gonna wait then.
Alright, so you're gonna wait. And then it proceeds to move towards you. Take your swing.
Swingy. Go magic dagger.
Go flaming dagger!
You hit him for 16 damage. It burns away all these little guys.
I burn, bitch.
Gideon Rain.
Okay, Gideon's gonna get to moving. Time to get out of here.
I'm well, still there's still one more right here. Sorry.
That one is still active.
Oh, the one's still active?
Right here. Sorry, guys.
That guy.
Okay, I will spam at him then.
Go for it. He makes his save.
Okay, then.
Alright, Rook, go ahead. Also, you're going further in, not up and not out?
Well, there's stuff behind us, right? Yeah. Going farther in.
Okay.
What if it's a dead end?
Well, then we...
I'm going to swing with a torch.
Alright, swing with your torch. You swing with your torch and you kill it. Congratulations.
Yay.
I did not mean to do that twice.
Oh. I think you... That technically means you missed. You rolled a critical one, and then you rolled... Actually, you have two attacks per turn, don't you? What level are you? You know you don't.
No, next level I get two attacks.
Okay, next. So you actually missed. Italian Silverleaf, it is your turn, and these guys will get a shot at Rook.
Oh, he's on me now?
Yeah, they're on you.
With the dagger again, burned them off.
You take... Wow, I critted. You take 11 damage.
Ah!
That's
you don't take
hurt.
Poison, so don't worry about that.
Because I'm already freaking a nest.
No, because it requires them to dig into your skin for you to take that damage. It's kind of hard to do that unless they're big enough to bite into the skin.
I'm going to try to burn them off Ruck.
Yeah, take the swing. Dagger. Yeah. With that, you singe your little friend here, but he doesn't seem to take too much damage.
Gladly take it to get this off of me.
You should take half, but I will go ahead and reduce that a little more, so you take a quarter, which is 3.
Yeah.
Alright, there you go.
And I say, sorry.
Thank you!
Your friend seems fine, for the most part. Alright, if you guys would like to proceed forward, you can. Or head back, but you do hear some noises, but it's up to you guys.
What kind of noises?
You don't hear clicking, if that's what you're waiting for.
That's good.
Nope.
That's from behind us or ahead?
From behind you. You don't hear clicking from behind you. There is some noises in front. You hear something in the back, but it's not clicking. It's like slow-moving footsteps.
Footsteps. Okay, we're back in up.
Alright, I'll go ahead and end the initiative. You don't think you're in combat anyway.
We're backing up.
Are we leaving?
That's on you guys.
The footsteps are coming from behind, aren't they? Or from front?
Footsteps are coming from behind us, and there's another noise coming from ahead.
Yes.
There's footsteps coming from behind us?
Yes.
I'll just throw my bow again.
I'm just going to remove these spiders from the map, so you don't constantly think they're coming back to life.
Okay.
I'll look here to the back, see what's coming.
Alright, take a look to the back. You hear it still heading towards you, but it's not in your visual range yet.
Can I someone there? Ready an arrow?
You want to ready an arrow? Yes, you can.
I'm going to ready an arrow and start aiming towards that side.
Alright, what about everyone else?
I want to call out to it. Someone there?
No response.
Gideon is just gonna raid. Is Root just gonna ready a spell? Probably guiding bolt.
Okay, you ready guiding bolt?
Yes.
And as you turn around, you see this little thing, kind of like just barely coming in your visual range on the bottom.
It's crawling.
It's a little wiggly thingy over there. I think you can see it if you look at it. I think you can see it. Can you not see it?
Yeah, I
see a little
see
yellow
it.
Line. Yeah.
Oh, no, that. Yeah, south.
Oh, that way, okay.
Yeah, it's a little thing over there. It's not really coming into your visual range. Your torch is... Well, you have a torch going, and it's just, like, peering around the corner.
Okay, I thought the footsteps were coming from behind us.
There.
You got things coming from both sides.
I'm looking behind.
All right, guys, let's just not stand here and wait.
We're surrounded.
Pick a direction, let's go. I don't want to have to face two things in, you know, one in each direction. We fight one, or we fight the other. I'm not fighting both.
We're in a hallway, we don't have a choice.
Yes, we do. We turn around and we either go back or we go forward. I'm not going to stand here and wait, though.
I'll follow you. Just start moving.
All right, then. I'm heading back the way we came.
All right. I will go ahead and let you guys decide in the order in which you stand, because it'll be hard to move in between each other once combat starts.
I'd say Rook stays in front, okay. And I'll stay second.
Okay, I'll bring up the back.
Alright. So, as you proceed along here...
I'll give the torch to Gideon, so I can two-hand my sword again.
Okay, I can do that.
Alright, rolling, and what do we have? That will do. It's making sure. Does it work properly? Yes, it does. You see a creature barely fitting through the hallway, just slowly stomping his way into the room.
We got a big guy.
As you look at it, it looks like a cyclops, but it does not have an eye. As you look at it, it seems to be undead or some weird-looking creature, anyway.
Can it see you?
It can still see you. It's definitely heading towards you guys.
Oh, all the dead things! I want to prepare an attack.
Yes, you will get your prepared attack.
Ah!
We're going to roll initiative, but you guys will get your prepared attacks as it gets close to you. Alright, you get a prepared attack and then your actual attack. And then Skype failed, which is amazing, guys.
Only for Horatio. Damn it, he got higher than me.
Alright. He's rebooting. So, let's see. Well, if he hadn't, we could have started the combat a little bit, but Brook, you get a reaction as he gets close to you, and then we'll proceed from there.
It's definitely an attack.
Oh! Nice swing!
It's a crit! A heal!
Damn! What in the world?
I got minimum crit damage, and it's still 21.
Damn. Damn.
Also, no, you didn't get minimum. You just rolled a 1 in that roll.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, okay. I will leave it up to you. You can choose to do your thing and absorb some blood into the sword, which would heal you, but it's undead. Do you want to risk it?
Do I have a choice when it does it? I thought it did it by itself.
The sword will suck it in on a crit. It's up to you whether or not you want to, heal from it. But it might not heal you if it's already dead, you know? So I'm leaving the choice up to you. It'll still deal the extra damage. And maybe it heals, maybe it doesn't.
Well, it... Okay, from character perspective, it's worked every single time. And I don't think he would actually know that it's by will. It would that it just happens every single time. So I don't think he would know it's under his full control. All
right. If that's, if that's
would
what
go
the character
through.
Leaves, then yeah, he'll just go ahead and do it.
Yep.
As far as you're aware, you take no damage, but you also note that the creature doesn't seem to take any additional damage from the necrotic damage.
And I'm back.
Okay.
All right. So he takes, I believe, 33.
43.
Yeah, doesn't your crit include the 10? The 10 necrotic.
No. Wait. I just put in...
Yeah, I'm seeing a plus 10. Is it the plus 10 necrotic?
Yes. Yes, it is. Okay,
so he takes 33.
33.
Yeah. It'd be very obvious that necrotic damage probably doesn't do anything to zombies.
Yeah.
But radiant, on the other hand.
Yeah.
But so, again, that's magic stuff. I don't know about that.
You cut into it. Your sword doesn't seem to do anything to you. You expected it to heal you, but at least nothing else. You're coming to the conclusion that maybe it doesn't work with undead.
Okay.
And I need to zoom out more so they don't have to constantly control the Twitch stream video. All right. I'm not used to it because usually I use one monitor. Now I have two, so I have to constantly look between the two of them.
It's so hard going back to one after you've had two.
It's so convenient. So, Talion, it is your turn. Go for it.
Is he on Skype again?
I think so.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, okay.
And then after this combat, we'll take a short break.
I'll just shoot it with sharpshooter.
All right.
My own bow.
I think you have to get a little bit.
That's a critical fail. Damn. Roll me a d10.
You might have to move to get a sight on him.
It's large enough that I would say he has, sight on a body part, if not the entire creature.
Okay.
But, yeah, with sharpshooter, he does allow him to shoot creatures in half cover, you know?
Oh, yes.
So, yeah, you take a shot, your bow doesn't break, you didn't hit your allies by accident, your arrow just, smacks and cuts into the wall and sort of just sits there.
That's good.
Brook, your turn. This thing looks like it could hit like a truck. Or
yeah,
an elephant.
Kind of assumed. I'm going to attack, though. Oh!
It's one end and the other. Roll me your d10.
Don't decapitate me, please.
I don't think you're close enough for that.
Five. On a five, you nearly lose your sword out of your hand as it cuts into like this guy's toenail, essentially.
Okay. I would like to use bonus action to second wind.
Go for it.
1d10, I believe, plus my things.
Plus, I think your level or con mod, I don't know.
It was my level. I don't
remember
that. I'm pretty sure it was a 1d10.
Alright. As you're right in front of him, he slowly lifts up this huge club. It's gonna be very hard for him to miss, especially in this hallway.
Yep.
And as he comes down, it critical misses.
Fantastic.
Get a one. He didn't get a one. Yeah, it smashes against the floor, and you narrowly dodge it.
Just because it's huge.
Yes, yeah. It's huge. It almost fills the hallway.
Oh.
Alright, Gideon Rain.
Gideon is doing his guiding bolt thing. Oh, good one.
You strike into him, dealing 19 damage.
Radiant
damage.
19 radiant damage. You think it seared away at the flesh of the creature, dealing slightly more damage.
Yay! Before my turn is over, I'm going to turn around and look down the hallway behind us. I want to make sure nothing's not coming in my back.
You still see that thing, and it's there, but it's, for the time being, not entering the room.
Okay.
Right. It's probably afraid of that thing.
Many things will be afraid of that thing. Also, looks like World 20 has connection.
I saw that.
Message.
You guys too?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Well, let's finish our combat, and then we'll take a short.
And break. Then we'll deal with technical issues.
Pretty much.
Better music.
Yeah. Hopefully, we can get some music going as well.
So, oh, thank you, Dink.
Gideon just went. So, Talion.
I'm gonna try to shoot it again with my longbow.
The first attack against it has advantage, so you have advantage.
That's a crit. Then.
I don't see it.
I have 22 and a 24.
I will accept that, because I can't see it.
Damage is 19, critical, 5.
We're all disconnected from each other, so we're just going to like have our own little private
I can't see a thing.
I'm fine with that. We're just trying to get this done, because it's really just one creature.
On
you guys
I'll
should be able to win.
Skype.
So, sure, let me take a look.
It's on Skype.
All right, you hit, and you had advantage, so you crit, so you deal 14 damage. Way to go, man.
24. Where's the attack?
24? Okay, 24. There we go. Take a nice big chunk out of this guy. You shoot him, and your arrow hits him, and you see the arrow plop out the other end with like a piece of his flesh stuck to it.
My third crit today.
Nice. Very nice. Hi. Rook, it's your turn, man.
Okay, I'm just gonna go for another swing. 10. So,
no.
I assume.
You no longer have less and
yeah.
You no longer. Like, the guiding bolt only works on the first deck after.
Okay, so that'll be a miss then?
Yes. Alright. The Cyclops readies another attack as he lifts his club again. Can't swipe it, but it'll take his shot down. 13 is going to miss.
Yep.
Damn, come on. He should be hitting. The game wants you guys to survive so hard.
You kind of deserve it.
Alright, he also moved there, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter where he stands. Because he can't get past Brook here.
He really doesn't like the floor.
Alright.
It's going to be rough terrain soon.
All right.
It's technically been rough terrain this entire time, with the webbing and the rough floors you've been setting on.
Okay, I am guessing this thing is pretty darn tore up right now.
Yeah, there's like a noticeable chunk like in his gut just missing right now.
All right, then I'm going to cast Shillelagh then, and then step up and give him a whack with my staff.
All right. I don't suppose Shillelagh's radiant damage, is it?
No, I don't believe so, but it is considered a magical weapon.
All right, take a swing. As the 19 does hit, takes 11, but it's still barely alive.
Okay.
Let's see two people critically miss so we can get one more shot at you guys.
So Talion's turn?
Yes. Talion, are you there?
Yes, I'll shoot it again. Just what I'm good at, shooting stuff.
Miss.
That's a miss.
That's come on, man. Good. So come on, let this guy hit you. You're gonna let him hit you, thanks.
God damn it.
Alright, he gets one last shot at hitting you guys, come on.
This is the part where you're gonna get raped.
Yeah, really, like, we're just gonna implode.
Boom.
Alright. Unfortunately, Gideon is here as well, so I'll roll D2 for that. Technically, it would just... Realistically, in the real world, you guys are in the hallway. He would probably hit both of you, but he hits. There we go.
Yeah.
It's gonna decide on one or the other. Alright, he is going to continue hitting Rook. He doesn't like you, man.
He does
Nobody
not.
Nobody likes Rook.
I'm the tank. It's supposed to be like that.
He winds up, takes a swing, and 19. Yes.
Oh yeah, that hits.
It hits. It hits. 16 damage. He smacks you as hard as he can. Roll me his strength, unless you'd like to be knocked back 5 feet and prone. Let's see. It,
12 only.
DC is you fail. You are knocked back 5 feet. You are prone, but since it is your turn next, you can just stand there.
Oh,
well, it's my turn next, isn't it?
No, that's after. Is Rook, then Cyclops, then Gideon, sorry. So,
okay.
Unfortunately, Rook, you're still on the floor. But...
I missed my attack, yeah.
Let's go ahead, let's see, this thing's undead, so we're going to go ahead and stick to the radiant damage, because it does seem to work well with it. So, let's go ahead and, let's spam the cantrip again.
Go for it. And it
Dexter.
Is it dead? It is dead!
Yay!
Bathed in radiant light, and you see the flesh of this beast just sear away from it, and it just collapses on the floor.
Let's see, how many spells do I have left?
Background noise going on, guys.
Okay, I've got one first level spell yet. I'm gonna go ahead and use it on Rook. Nobody else is taking damage, correct?
Correct.
I've been doing my job as the tank.
Indeed, he's been doing it well.
There you go, 13 points.
Nice. All
right. So unless you like some Cyclops club or other appendages, it's not really much to loot from a dead guy.
Okay.
Oh, hey, Rook.
Yes.
That macro that I put in Skype, that's for your second
I
win.
I saw that.
Yeah, if you just pop it in there, and it'll keep track of your level, so you don't ever have to mess with it, no matter what level you are again. Just put in your class actions under output.
Do I need the brackets?
Yeah, the whole thing. The whole thing goes in there, just under class action. Mark it, you know, in the description part, and the name is Second Wind, and down there where it says Output, just copy-paste that in there.
Oh, very helpful.
Yeah, you don't even have to mess with it again, because it'll keep track even at your level.
Alright, so as you finally get a good look at this thing, as it moves further up along the hallway. It's moving too slow to catch up to you guys.
Ooh, what is it?
Take a look, you can see it.
It's big, gray, and gloppy. That's all I see.
Exactly.
Oh god, it's an ooze. It's an ooze, we don't want to mess with oozes.
We should leave.
Yep.
We should leave.
Alright, assuming that Gideon can cast that spell on the mushroom again, I assume you can, right?
Nope, I've only got one per day.
All right, guys. Well, let's... How do you want to handle that? And well, you guys can decide that on your way over there.
Yeah. Running.
Can I ask one of you guys to take care of this pixel? So you guys, Twitch can actually see you guys better.
What?
The little light source that is there for Twitch so they can see the show we're doing. So you guys should be able to control that. You can do it
for
me.
I can do it.
Okay, well, if we can't get past Mushroom Bob, we may just have to kill him.
Yeah.
That's up to you guys.
Which way did we come from?
This way.
Yeah, I get you're an orc man, but you're not that silly. Yeah, that room's dark for no reason, don't worry about it.
I do have an int of one, I've been trying to do a little bit of that. Oh, shit.
Plus one int is the average, intelligence of a person.
No, I meant minus one int.
Close your eyes.
Oh god, that's right, yeah, close your eyes, run down the hall.
Yeah. It's fine. Like, at the end of the day, you know how to bypass it. So it happens for that brief moment, the first one who walks in and forgets.
Okay, let's see. Scroll the map over. We're going north, north, north. Gotcha. Okay, I'm going to tell everybody, hey, guys, just be quiet as you can, and just try and run past Bob.
That's not really a thing for me.
Alright, he's right there, guys.
Alright. Kill him or run like hell?
Let's just run, because I can't sneak.
Okay, run like hell.
I'm gonna try to dash through a block.
Okay, running is an athletics check.
I hate athletics.
Not my forte, athletics.
Oh god.
Okay, well, Rook made it. Unfortunately, no one else did. So
let's see. How many of these things do I have a day?
Let me go ahead and position you guys. So, Rook, you're over here. Talion and Gideon. I'm going to say one on each side. How about that? So as you make it right there and there, you two are caught by those little tangling mushrooms that are along the floor. And Roach just manages like muscle his way past all of it.
Should we roll initiative?
That's really up to you. What do you think? What do you think he's gonna do? We never really identified whether or not Bob is aggressive.
Yeah, I don't think Bob's ever actually attacked us. It's just the little mushroom things around him.
Yeah.
Well, it's up to you. If you don't think he's aggressive and don't decide to roll initiative, he will have an advantage on his attack, as it would be surprised. As he attacks you.
Yeah, I don't have to.
Initiative.
I can't do it again.
Alright, he moves a little closer to Talion.
Oh god, I want to roll initiative.
Go ahead, Talion. If anyone else would like to roll initiative, they can, but you're essentially placing yourself in an aggressive stance if you do that.
I'm just aggressive towards the shrooms that are trying to grab me. And I'm gonna try to make them... The shrooms are not connected with Bob, are they?
They don't appear to be.
And I'm gonna try to take out my flaming dagger and cut the vines or shrooms that are grabbing towards me.
Damn, Bob. Horrible roll, man. Alright. So Talon, as top initiative, you begin... to cut away with the flaming dagger, I assume.
Yep.
Right. He starts slashing away at this little guy, and Bob is still just stomping his way towards you. But he won't move until it's an issue. Rook, what are you doing?
Save me!
I don't think you're in danger right now, honestly, because the last mushroom I talked to was an old friend of mine.
Yeah, but it wasn't this big.
No, it wasn't.
Five is intimidating.
I'm just waiting there for you guys.
All right.
I'm holding.
You pass your turn. You're holding in a, let's say, at least a defensive stance.
Yep.
Bob moves right on top of you, man. He's still really just, like, staring at you right now.
Hi.
What are you waiting for? Come on.
Gideon, we're going to give you your turn before we start the next round. Is there anything in particular you would like to do, or are you just like to walk, try to walk past?
I'm going to just not attack anything. I'm just going to try and muscle my way through these little mushrooms.
Athletics.
Athletics again. Yay. All right. Yay!
17,
me.
You make it. Congratulations.
Yay.
You end up right about here. Or that works too, I guess.
Okay, I'm going to tell Bob bye, Bob.
He turns to look at you for a moment as you see him winding up. Talion, what do you do? He's stretching up to you right now.
Can I acrobatically, like, do a combat roll under his, through his legs?
He wants to roll acrobatics.
Okay, here's the thing. You would have a disadvantage because of the way the floor is scuffed up, and because you are essentially in, the tangling vines. So you would have disadvantage, and if you fail, you would be rooted to the floor prone.
Oh, no.
So if you fail, you are screwed. If this guy attacks you, he'll kill you right then and there. It's like you have zero AC when you're literally tied to the floor at that point.
Dude, just try
to run. Run through his legs without rolling.
Okay, well, you'd be moving at half moon speed, and you know what? We're going to find out right now if he's aggressive. As far as you're aware, he did not attack you.
So, like, just... Hold on.
And then he turns around and just stares at you.
Bob, you're not going to hurt my little friend over there, are ya?
Rook, it's your turn. Talion has not actually made it out of the grasping mushroom yet.
Quit goofing off, Talion! Let's get out of here. I'm gonna start, like, heading towards over here.
Alright.
I guess we're waving goodbye to Talion, too.
Yeah. Bye, Bob.
Talion, what do you do, man?
I'm gonna try to... I'm still half speed, am I not? 3 steps here.
Alright. He attempts to follow you guys out, but at the end of the day, you guys, he can't even fit through the doorway. Whether he's actually attacking or aggressive, he's just... following you around, man.
He's just there.
I like to think he's just bored and wants a little human, you know, contact.
Bye, Bob.
Bye, Bob.
Alright, guys. I got my whole dungeoneering thing out of my system. We can leave now if you want.
Yes. It would have been nice if you had gone a little further, but, you know, there's always more down there.
Eh, it's XP. What the hell? Plus, I found a dagger pendant kind of thingy.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
I never went down.
Here's a quick way to show you how big the dungeon is, but feeling the map. So, from where you guys are currently, it's 430 feet south. Can you see that?
Shit.
Yeah.
Wow.
It's a big one.
Yeah.
We didn't even check this thing, a quarter of this thing, did we?
Well, let's see.
No.
430 from where your current location, if you head all the way up top, it's 555. And 555 by 405. It's up to you, man. You want to crunch the numbers and figure out how much you've seen and how much you haven't.
We're about a quarter.
Yeah, I don't even think we've seen a quarter of this thing yet. But you know what? The horses are getting distressed. You know, we're in and out of this place so damn much.
We finished our quest. I have legs in my arm. I have eggs in my arm. I'm pretty grossed out about this whole place.
God,
there's a lot of undead things. I think I'm done with this place for now.
Man, you're such a little pansy.
Man, undead things and bugs. Now. No.
Oh, and you don't put your hand in squishy stuff, and...
Well, that's just gross things, man. They're gross.
Well, we're pretty sure we heard a dragon, or at least I'm sure I heard one.
You all heard something roaring that caused the entire building to shake. Whether or not it's a dragon, it's really up to you to decide.
Since I have favored enemy dragons, do I know if it was a dragon roar?
You make the assumption it's a dragon. You can't confirm unless you, you know, made a check and you didn't make one in the moment.
Undead dragon or something.
Undead
dragon. Oh god.
Okay, when we get outside, Deacon is going to cast Detect Magic on his little dagger pendant thing.
Alright, you will cast Detect Magic on the dragon pendant thing.
I'm going to do it as a ritual, though.
Right. I don't have the right image.
Oh.
I was going to freak you out. No, that's not there. I have to change it later. Okay, so you cast it as a ritual, Detect Magic, on the little pendant dagger. It does seem to have some sort of magic. As to exactly what it does, Detect Magic only tells you the nature of the magic, right?
Bummer. Yeah, I wish... And old Deacon doesn't have Identify, so... Or, Gideon doesn't have Identify, so...
Yeah, well... There's the Town of Adventures about a week from here. No,
yep.
Let's just have him take care of it.
Also a blacksmith.
So
yeah.
When you look at the little amulet on the bottom end of that, it has this weird depiction of like some sort of creature, though you're not really sure what it looks like. It's like, well, it's there, but it's all like crusted over with like gunk and stuff. Maybe you could have Rook clean it up, or it's really up to you what you want to do with it. As far as you know, it could be cursed. And your Detect Magic just tells you it's magic.
Yep, we're not putting it on or anything. We're just holding on to it until we know what it is.
All right.
Trust,
it's all rusted over.
Fairly fast when you get yourself a bag of holding and you put all your stuff in it. And then when you reach into the bag of holding, you find out it's all been devoured.
Yeah, that's great sometimes.
Yeah, you don't just automatically start using magic stuff.
Unless you have like a bunch of food just handy for it to eat.
Alright, so... are the horses looking better and everything now that they've had some water?
Now that they've had some water, they're definitely a lot better than they were before.
Is it still scorching hot?
It's still scorching hot out.
Okay.
Literally at this point, they're like... The horses would have a sunburn if they had not fur all over their bodies.
Okay, guys. Well, how about this then? How about we go ahead and rest during the day and travel at night? Easier on the horses, easier on us.
We could do that. We could use the trees for cover.
We could do that.
Okay, cool. So let's go ahead and do the, what time of day is it now?
Let's see. We woke up originally
early afternoon.
Yeah, maybe? Like early afternoon.
Okay, cool. We'll go ahead and take an 8-hour now, though. Now then.
Yeah, we could even just take a short rest and start walking around sunset.
I've got two second level spells yet left. If we've got 8 hours till it gets dark, I'd like to use it up.
All right, that sounds good to me.
Okay.
So we're gonna take a quick actual break.
Yep.
So if anyone's watching the stream, thanks for showing up. We'll be back in, let's say, 5 minutes, guys.